Hello everyone and welcome back to APWC. I finally watched Furiosa, a Mad Max saga, and decided to review it. This may contain spoilers. So, without wasting any time, let's begin.
Ready.
Furiosa is the prequel to 2015's Mad Max Fury Road and tells the story of Charlize Theron's character Imperator Furiosa, which is played by Anya Taylor-Joy. The uncanny resemblance between both Charlize Theron and Anya Taylor-Joy in their Furiosa avatar was sufficient to understand why they chose a new actor to take over the role instead of de-aging. I spoke about Mad Max Fury Road, which by all means is one of the finest action films in the history of cinema. If you haven't watched that video, then click on the I card above. And if you haven't watched Mad Max Fury Road, फिर तो मैं बस एक ही चीज बोलूंगा।
अभी मैं गाली नहीं दे सकता।
नहीं गाली नहीं देना।
अब फैमिली देखती है, वरना मैं ऐसे-ऐसे गाली दूँ, ऐसे-ऐसे गाली दूँ ना ज़िंदगी भर याद रखें ये बड़े।
Coming back to Furiosa, I can only say that it's great, no doubt. But it has moments where you lose momentum, especially in the first half due to chapterization. Still, once it gains momentum, you will be glued to your seat, just like Mad Max Fury Road. The action sequences are without any doubt the highlight of this film, and they are amazing. Whilst you're watching, you'll be amazed as to how they even thought of something like that. Director George Miller, who has directed close to 4 Mad Max films, has again done a fantastic job at creating a visual masterpiece, keeping the storyline in mind. I spoke about him as well in my Mad Max review. The entire punishment sequence of Dementors at the end was so poetic. Growing an entire fucking peach tree by using a living human body as fertilizer has to be hands down the most torturous punishment I have seen. The only thing I am unable to comprehend is that made on a budget of close to $168 to $233 million, Furiosa grossed $168 million. The development of Mad Max Wasteland, which was hanging on the success of Furiosa, seems a little bleak and uncertain as of now. I know that the development was stalled for several years due to compensation disputes, and maybe the delay of Furiosa after the massive success of Mad Max Fury Road can be considered as the okayish response that Furiosa got during its theatrical run. Or are the female-led action films genuinely having a tough time at the theaters, irrespective whether they are good or bad? Something to think about. Anya Taylor-Joy plays the titular character, Furiosa, and she has done a fabulous job. But we also see younger versions of that character. Young Furiosa was played by Aliala Brown. Anya Taylor-Joy doesn't even appear until 1 hour into the film, except that her face was partially superimposed on that of Aliala Brown playing the younger version. Chris Hemsworth, who plays Dementors, is such a well-written antagonist. He is a lunatic by all means and has no real emotions. Tom Burke, who plays Praetorian Jack, was a beautiful character. And that's why maybe Furiosa feels that there are similarities between Max and Jack, as the events of Mad Max Fury Road take place 4 years after the end of Furiosa. Many actors like Nathan Jones, John Howard, Angus Sampson, Josh Helpman return to play characters from Mad Max Fury Road. Although Hugh Keyes Bryan played Immortan Joe in Mad Max Fury Road due to his demise, Lachie Hulme played Immortan Joe in Furiosa along with the character of Rizdale, Dementus' lieutenant. Elsa Patkey, who is Chris Hemsworth's wife, plays two roles, Mr. Norton, a deformed survivor, and a Vivalini general. Jacob Tomori, who was Tom Hardy's stunt double in Mad Max Fury Road, gives a brief cameo as Max Rokitansky. There is also archive footage in the end which shows how Furiosa took the 5 wives which led to the events of Mad Max Fury Road. Verdict: I'll happily give Furiosa, a Mad Max saga, 4 out of 5 stars. As a prequel, it is great, only once it catches momentum. It tries hard to reach the supremacy of Mad Max Fury Road, but ends up becoming a runner-up. Still, it's a worthy prequel, which should not be missed at any cost.
The question is, do you have it in you to make it epic?
That's it for this video, guys. Comment on your thoughts on Furiosa, a Mad Max saga, and I'll see you guys in the next one. और हाँ, अगर वीडियो अच्छा लगे तो सब्सक्राइब कर देना दोस्तों, मिलते हैं अगली बार. Till then, bye.